Today, a little video about risk management. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Phu Quoc in Vietnam. I was on a call a few days ago with someone that didn't have really much risk management, or at least he thought he had. He thought he worked hard on it and kind of got his risk together and his money management plan together. But I quickly realized that the plan was not really sensible, that it wouldn't really work well for the long term. So I want to show with you today kind of what I took from that call, the lessons I gave that guy, and kind of how you can apply the same thing to your own trading. Now, quick context here a little bit before we start. This guy's been using our trading assistant services for some time. He's really happy with it. A lifetime member now, which is awesome. So this is a tool where you can get alerts for trades set up on the spot when they happen on your phone, which is really epic. Really helped me a lot as well to follow the trades and stuff in the market. But so the principle is that this guy made a lot of money 1 month with that service and lost and went in kind of a drawdown this past month. Not because of the singles, but because of the way his risk was managed. And I think that's a common pitfall that a lot of people can fall into. So here's the thing. He's now in a drawdown of 37.8%, something of the sort. The point is that he calculated his maximum drawdown and said that he was comfortable losing at least 40% to 50% of his accounts, at least a 40 to 50% drawdown. Now, that might seem fine, like, oh, you lose 50%, you recover, boom, you're successful, like, forever. And then you make a lot of money. That's pretty cool. The only issue is that if you lose, let's say 37.8%, the amount of percentage you gotta gain back to go back to zero is a lot. It's a lot more. As a matter of fact, now I have to get back 60.7% just to get back to break even, which is pretty insane. That's gonna take you a long time. And so this guy was risking about, I think, 3 to 5% a trade, which isn't too bad. But once you get to a 10 trades drawdown, which is normal because you trade a lot of pairs and everything, that's fine. That happens. That's normal, right? You gotta think about probabilities and stuff, and the fact that the market is random. So the market doesn't care how many losses you've had in the past or how long you've been trading for, it doesn't care. So you gotta be able to kind of sustain the drawdown no matter how they happen. And that's why people risk a low amount of money per trade. Now the other issue with this is the fact that you gotta calculate your maximum drawdown wisely. You might think your maximum drawdown is like 50%, but how did you get this 50%? So if you've backtested like 20 pairs for the past year and that you've got 20 trades per pair, that's a lot of trades still. But that doesn't mean that's going to be accurate. That's a low number of trade per pair to calculate a proper drawdown. Like, that's only 1 year. If you expect to make a living trading for, let's say, the next 10, 20 years, how can you just look at 1 year of data? That doesn't make sense, right? You got to look at more than that. You got to be able to look at what you are going to expect later on from the past. And the past means a lot more data to predict a lot more future. Not just like, oh, a year to predict like the next 10 years. That doesn't work, right? Because the markets change, the market evolve, things are never constant. And that's why you gotta be able to do your due diligence first and test it out first properly. So I would recommend at least like doing 10 years. And if you're gonna be testing manually, 10 years might be long, but if you're gonna do it with a script, which is not hard to do, then 10 years is totally fine, okay? So when people buy the trading assistant, we provide them sometimes with the script. They can backtest, you just gotta ask for it, and we'll send it to you. So you can kind of backtest stuff with that script and make sure you get the stats for every pair you trade, okay? And every time frame. And then you're gonna make sure, like I said before, that you are able to recover from your drawdowns. If you got a drawdown like 20%, that's not too hard to recover. You need to make back 25%, which might take some time, but still doable. I tend to prefer like a 10% drawdown. For me, that's like kind of my maximum, my personal max. Because I feel like more than that, I'm kind of getting too hammered and I feel like it's harder to take trades. And the other thing you gotta think about is the fact that if you get in a big drawdown, well, you tend to make mistakes and you tend to force things because you want to get back quickly. Like, you don't want to stay in the drawdown for some time. You don't want to be there and because it's kind of painful. So you want to get back to normal. And getting back to normal is done by you forcing trades, you pushing things to happen, and you trying to do things that you shouldn't do normally. and that's the other issue. So even though you have a system of alerts for trades, notification you get on your phone or whatever, even though you have that, you might force trades. You can like trade more pair, get more time frame, this and that, less fixed rules, or oh, it looks like it's fine, I'll take it anyway. Those are things you gotta think about, right? So those are things that even algo traders face. They might decide to, because they wanna get back to break even, put their algos in like 5 more time frame and not test it because like, they wanna make money quickly. And that's usually a recipe for disaster. So you gotta be smart and you gotta do things right. My last point, something I said that I think really makes sense. Let's say you're trading with an account of $50,000 and that's your account that you're gonna have. And you wanna be able to make a living for that account. So you're gonna risk a higher amount of money on that account. Let's say 3%, 4%, 5% per trade. Now that's fine. You might make a living, right? But think about what you prefer. Do you prefer having that account of $50,000 risking more, meaning more risk to lose your account with the advantage of making some money perhaps, versus you prefer to risk less, like maybe 0.5%, but be able to trade a $2 million account from investors, okay? The answer that I pick and the answer I would pick and most people would pick is investor. Like you prefer to trade for someone else. It's more safe, it's more capital, you get more reward, more return over time, and that's why you gotta do things smart. If an investor sees that you've been risking a lot, going back and forth with your risk and stuff, he's not gonna give you money. But if he sees that you've been diligent, took the right step, did the right things, have a risk and check all the time, like consistently, he's gonna be happy. And one thing I've learned over time is that investors care a lot more about the risk than the return. They prefer low risk and low return as opposed to high risk and high return. So you gotta keep that in mind. If your goal is straight for investors, which is I think these days fairly simple to do, then you gotta kind of put things in check. And even if you make a lower amount now, it's all about delaying that return, that gratification to later. And that is gonna be done by trading for an investor or someone else and making a lot more money and finally getting the lifestyle you want. So I hope that makes sense. These are my thoughts on the topic, risk management, money management, everything in between. Let me know your thoughts on below in the comment section. I want to hear your comments as well. Here are a few comments from Passive. I appreciate you guys for leaving comments as always. And I'll catch you back here in Fukuoka for a last video here tomorrow. Ciao.